act of contrition, the act of contrition, even if you don't go to confession, this will be good for you, because we're going to surrender our lives to the Lord. Okay, for a minute now, just close your eyes, and I want you to think, is there one area, one main area, where you're in a cage, where you feel stuck, where you are stuck in the web? Is there an addiction that's got a hold of you, a bad habit? Are you angry? Are you mad at somebody? You're not forgiving? Are you negative? Are you feeling guilt, shame, condemnation? Well, I pray that this will be a special night for you of anointing, of power, of freedom. And then please take that holy audacity, that determination as you leave here. And then for those of you who will go to confession, receive the sacrament and walk in freedom. Walk in the freedom that Jesus paid the price for you to have. So now let's do what we can do by surrender. Okay, open your eyes. Act of contrition. Together let us pray that prayer. Jesus, I am sorry for my sins. I surrender my life to you now. I believe in your love and forgiveness. Take, Lord, receive all that I am. I love you, Lord Jesus. Amen. And I pray for all the people, Lord, that your anointing would touch them. Tomorrow night they come, be filled with the Holy Spirit. And tonight, for all that you are calling to confession, I pray that they will be brave and courageous and listen to your voice. I pray especially for those who are addicted and they've been denying it, that they've been struggling with it. I pray that they'll be rigorously honest, they'll admit it, and that they will surrender and walk in freedom. And I pray that you will know that you can change. Change is possible. It's not too late. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Would you have a seat just for a minute? I want to explain. If you didn't get one of these sheets, we made 1,000 of them, so we got plenty. So just get one on the way out. You can take it home with you, the examination of conscience. That's to help you to be rigorously honest. Your penance tonight, for those of you who go, by the way, if you haven't been in 25 years, there's no color TV over there, and there's no cigars or anything like that. But here's what you do. You make the sign of the cross. Tell us how long it's been since you've been to confession. For some of you, it's been a month. Some of you, it's been 30 years. I think my record is like 62 years in Mankato. But anyway, you know, whatever it is, you just come. Since there's only, I think, 5 priests here tonight and 500 people, it'd be pretty good that if you just announce a couple areas, we can't really get into counseling with you. There'll be some long lines. So here's what you do. Just tell us a couple areas. We will absolve you personally. Your penance is Psalm 51, which is on there. Read it, pray it while you're in line. And then simply go home. After we absolve you, go home. Some of you won't be going to confession. We'll see you back tomorrow morning, tomorrow evening. But if you do go to confession, just get in the lines. We'll absolve you personally, and you go home. So let me see here. Father Chris, would you come up just for a minute and tell us who the priests are and where the stations are? In other words, tell us where to go. And then I'll dismiss you in just a minute. I hope everybody has a safe trip home.
Good evening. I'd like to welcome my brother priests. We have Father Tim Babcock, who is administrator here. He was a longtime pastor at St. Andrew's in Rochester. He's done lots of work for the Archdiocese. He's very pastoral and easy to talk to. And Father Tim's station will be the back prime room. So that little room back there, and you can go through that door where it says exit and go see him in there. Secondly, I want to introduce Father Gene Ketcher. Father Gene is back here. And he will be hearing confessions by that bank of windows. Father Gene, like myself, has just come to Canton in July, and he's our neighbor down the street at Resurrection Parish here in Canton. So we welcome him to the neighborhood and also welcome to the parish. Father Phil Paxton, is he here?
Yes, he is.
Oh, really? Oh, there he is. Father Phil is a fellow Passionist.
Yes.
He belongs to the Passionist community here in Detroit. Father Cedric is at the Passionist community down in Houston, and so Father Phil graciously agreed to help us out with his brother priest. Father Phil will be then Father Cedric, you were to be right over there underneath the banner, and I'm Father Chris, and I will be right under the banner over there. Okay? I try to give people some space, try to respect the quiet and the meditative time that we have together while people are waiting to go to reconciliation. And like Father Cedric said, once you're done, you're free to leave. Thank you.
Okay, thanks, Chris. Appreciate it. Okay, everybody rise. I'll dismiss you. Thanks so much for coming, everybody. I really appreciate it. We'll see you back tomorrow. And remember now, all day tomorrow, you're going to be praying. The Lord be with you. Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, and we'll see some of you in confession. The others of you, we'll see you tomorrow. Thanks again for coming. My books are available. Be careful going home. Take your time.